Using Canva and Photopea, let's create this gorgeous circle S letter design. Let's open a canvas. We're going to do this in three steps. Step number one is to create your circles. Whether you go on your elements and you search for these round circles, or whether you use the shape of a circle and you create your own by adding a circle and then including a white round shape on top of it. Or you could pick the third option that I use when I was busy with this project. I tried all three shapes, including the half a circle shape. This one is called a half a circle. So if this is going to be better for you to tweak and have a small circle and a bigger circle, and you adjust it that way, use whichever one is going to be easy for you to maneuver the two round circles. Nailing the circles is how this project gets successful. So let's add our first circle, and this one is white in color. So our design, we're going to make a gold design, and you bring it to a large or a larger circle. I'm going to find a bigger circle for the small part of my design. And then I align them, and the size of the two are very similar. That's what you want with your design. You want it to be very, very close to each other and look quite professional. Next, you're going to press R for rectangle, or you can add the square shape and align your square shape on top of the two circles in such a way that you create a gap between the two. So we're going to reduce them so that we're at this point and at this point of the smaller circle, which we're also going to change to gold. And then the square shape we're going to change to white. We're trying to create a gap on the bigger circle and the smaller circle. Next, you're going to go to share, and you're going to download this as a PNG. Doesn't matter if you make it transparent or not, because Canva doesn't create the gaps for us anymore. Then you're going to log into remove.bg, and then you're going to grab the circle and drop it to remove.bg to take away the white as well as the background. Then you're going to download that and go back to your design, and you remove the shapes so that you have again a blank canvas. You're done with step number one. Step number two, you're gonna go to your shapes, and you're going to create the drop of the S. I have found a beautiful font that I'm going to be creating a video of, and that has these drops in the font itself, but I'm going to create the video later this week. So you're going to add a heart. We're going to change the heart and make it gold, and press C for circle and change the color to gold, and then align the two together. You're creating the back end of your S design. Align them so that it creates a teardrop. So we're going to group these two shapes, and you're going to reduce the teardrop. And then you're going to put that on the side. And then we can grab our round shapes and add them to the design. Perfect. Then open an extra page. So you're going to press T for text. And you're going to type S. You change this to a font that you want to use. It could be Playfair Display, because Playfair is quite nice. And you want it to be a capital letter. You're also going to change this to a gold color. And then we all know that you can't crop text. Therefore, that's why we have to download this page as a PNG so that we're able to crop the page. So we're going to choose PNG and as a transparent background. And we're going to click done, and we download. Awesome. We don't need page number two anymore. We can delete it. And we go back to our first page, and we add the S shape to our design. So you're going to crop out the extra space of your S, and then we want to take off the tail of S because we've created our own tail for the design. Therefore, we're going to make it a bit large. Then you're going to select the S shape and click on edit image and then select crop. Canva's crop has a rotate and an aspect ratio that you could choose. So you're going to leave it as freeform, but you're going to rotate your S to a direction that changes it and it moves it in a way that you are able to enlarge it and then crop the tail. And this way allows us to crop it the way that we want because we have rotated it. And we click on done, and then you can rotate it back. Then you align it and edit to the middle of the page. For this design, we want the two circles to be completely separate from each other. So you're going to duplicate them, and then you're going to have a second one. So the second one you can crop out of the picture so that it's just waiting for us when we need to use it. And you leave it on the side. And then we want to make the bigger circle, and we will crop out the smaller circle. So you're going to enlarge it and align it to your design, and then you're going to edit the image. Let's just crop out the extra space. You're going to edit the image and you're going to crop, and then again you can rotate and crop out the smaller circle. Great stuff. We're going to rotate our design so that the circle and the S are aligned. We're going to enlarge this a little bit and then rotate it so that it is aligned to our bigger S. Then we're going to combine everything. Now the last step is to combine everything and have everything go the way that we want. So we're going to add our circle, adjust our S, once you've aligned your circles and your S, so you're going to press L for line, and your line, you're gonna make the color also gold, and then you're gonna increase the line so that it is the same weight as your circle, and you're going to zoom in so that you can control the line better. And then you're gonna reduce the line. And you edit to the S, and you're going to use the curved to have it curve like that. You still want to create a circle, so you're going to bend it and adjust it so that it is a circle. Last thing, you're going to add your dots, and we use our line and we adjust it. After making your adjustment and you're happy with your design and the last part of S looks the way it does and you're happy with your design, you're going to download the 2D as a transparent background and convert it to 3D, or you could use your mockups on Canva to convert it to whatever you want to convert. So we're going to select transparent background, and it is a pro feature. You can trial it with my link below if you want to, and then you can see how you like Canva Pro. You're going to access www.photopea.com, and you're going to go to your templates to convert this to a 3D. And you can pick any of these mockups that you would like to use. This is usually my favorite. I don't know why I like this mockup, but I do. And you're going to click and open it and select the link to open the actual mockup. Once it's loaded, you're going to access the checkered box and double click where it says your logo here, and you're going to hide the example. Go to your downloads and add the 2D logo. Adjust it and make it nice and huge, and press Command S or Control S to change it to Smart Object. And then you can click on your first tab to find your design. Looks absolutely stunning. I love it. You're going to go File, Export as a PNG, and then you have your design done and dusted. If you don't like the image that the mockup has for you, you can go watch this video of mine that's going to teach you how to change the background of your mockup to exactly what you want. I will see you with our next video.